Greetings, everyone. This video is going to teach you how to get an Alphabetize list for attendance in a meeting in Teams. So the first thing I'm going to do is head over to my team. And here inside Teams, you can see I still have a meeting going on. I haven't left it yet. So the first thing I'm going to do is get to my participants list by clicking on the people at the top. And then right at the top of my participants list, I'm going to click on the three dots for the more options, and I'm going to choose download attendance list. This is going to download an Excel spreadsheet into my downloads folder. Once I've got that downloaded, let's head over and find that spreadsheet. So now I'm in my downloads, and here is my meeting attendance list. If you needed to, you could change the name to make sure it reflects the date or time. So let's open that up. And it's going to look something like this. Now let's modify this a little bit to make it easier to work with. So the first thing I'm going to have you do is click on this little triangle right up here in the top left to select the entire sheet. And then we're going to move our cursor in between the A and B until we get this bracket shape with the two arrows and double click. This is the quickest way to automatically resize all of your columns so it fits the content. Next, I want you to notice something here. I have some repeating names. Some of these students seem to have left and joined. Some of them seem to have come in and out of the meeting. So I need to manipulate this. Additionally, you'll notice this is all by first name, last name organization. And focused is alphabetized by last name. So we need to fix that too. Now, right now, I'm not too worried about the joined and left, and I'm also not too worried about the timestamp. I know this happens to be my third period class. So I'm going to select those two. I'm going to right click and choose delete. So right now, I'm just worried about the names. Additionally, I don't even really need this title at the top, so I'm going to get rid of that too. So now let's get rid of some of these duplicate names. So I'm going to select the column, and then we're going to come up to the very top, and we're going to choose the Data tab. Once we get inside the Data tab, there's a button called Remove Duplicates. When we click Remove Duplicates, it's going to double check to make sure we've selected the correct column. I'm going to hit OK. And it automatically takes it down to one name per student. The next thing we need to do is change how this is organized. So I'm going to select the column again. I happen to still be on my Data tab, and I'm going to come over here and I'm going to choose Text to Columns. What this does is it allows me to break apart the text according to how it's delimited. So I'm going to leave this set as delimited. I'm going to hit Next. And the default setting is tab. Well, we don't have tabs in this list. We have spaces. So I'm going to uncheck tab, and I come down here and choose space. And you'll notice in the preview, it's already splitting first name, last name for us. So all I have to do is hit next and finish. And you'll notice that I now have a list of first names and a list of last names. If you happen to have had middle names or multiple last names, they would be in additional columns. But you do now have a list of last names. And the beautiful part is we can now sort and filter by that last name list. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to my home tab here at the top. I'm going to come over to the right hand side. We're going to choose sort and filter. And just simply choose sort A to Z. Now it's going to ask me, do I want to expand the selection? Yes, I do, because I want those first names still lined up with my last names. So I click sort, and it automatically alphabetizes my list, first names and last names for me. So to compare this over to Focus, all I have to do is pull both of them up, and it makes it very quick and simple. Hope that helps.